Good evening. Today we're going on a slightly different walk. We've left it a little later in the evening. It's been an absolutely lovely sunny day today, up to about 27, 28 degrees C. So it's now 7:30 in the evening and we're going out for a lovely cool evening walk now the temperature's dropped to about 26, 25. So we're on Horsell Common. I always get that confused because I used to live in Coventry near Horsell Common. This is Horsell Common. We're going to have a walk across here, have a look at the place where the aliens land in H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds. Potentially have a look at the back of McLaren's HQ Innovation Centre thing. And then have a walk up to an airfield I've forgotten the name of, but I'll look it up by the time we get there. So come along and join us on a lovely early evening walk. What is that sign? Is that no feeding the birds? Oh, it's about ground nesting birds and keeping dogs on the path. Ooh, there's a tree down. There's a few people around. Depending on the weather, it can be a little wet. Down here, there can be a little pond in the middle of here. But yeah, this is the location where the fictional alien spacecraft or pod in H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds lands, right in the middle of this sandpit. So probably about here. About here, I imagine. Now summer's come back round again, and with H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds being out of copyright, I do plan to film some videos around that at some point, but I wouldn't expect them anytime soon because there's going to be a lot of different bits and pieces that go into those videos. I seem to see a football goal over there in the woods.
It's a bit broken though.
It is a bit. We're coming to this car park here and then turning left, so I might come down past it.
It's a bit of an odd place to have a football pitch.
It is. But I can smell wood smoke, so potentially there's a cottage or something around here as well. Either that or the wood's on fire.
Don't say that, please.
We don't tend to get wildfires like they've got in Canada at the moment.
Well, there has been signs though.
There are signs saying high fire risk. I think this is the footpath. The sign's there. There isn't a footpath on this side of the hedge. So we must be talking about down this driveway. Those children animals really should speed up. But boom. Bad jokes, I know. Oh yeah, just over there. See, they've got a little bit of a clearing. I did wonder why there was a 5 mile an hour sign up at that gate, but it turns out this house is down here. Now I have to guess which way we go, but based on the mossy sign, we're going down here. Horse riding is not permitted on McLaren Park. Okay, so we're now going to McLaren Park. Off of Horsell Common. This looks like a very City of London-esque signpost. I think it is. I thought the sun was going down, it was starting to get dark, but it's just because we were on Horsell Common under the trees. Going into the field and it's still bright light. Don't know how well this is going to show up on video, but at least this little copse of trees here has a completely flat base. As Gary just said, like something out of a cartoon. But I suspect it's because this is managed land. This is, I think, land owned by McLaren. So I think they look after it. Let's just check that this sign doesn't say, do not go up to the trees, before I go up to the trees. No access to members of the public. Yeah, I'm not going to go up to the trees then. I think pretty much everything to the right of this path is McLaren private property. And everything to the left is also McLaren private property, but open to the public. If you were to look at that pond, it looks like it's raining. But I think that's insect activity. Also, pond might be a slightly grandiose term. You get some nice reflection shots from over here. The McLaren Technology Centre is starting to appear from behind the hill. they're saying more of these trees with the flat bottoms, but then they go on all the way over there. So maybe that's just the way these trees are. Or there's something that's eating anything it can reach. It looks like they've had some sort of event or something here. There's a load of dead flat ground. Looks like it's had tracks down, marquees or something. So whether they've had some test cars around here or something, who knows. We should walk on the footpath. Ooh, there's a pond over here as well, on the private property. And I think just like in the curve of that building, I think there's a pond with some fountains that you can just about hear. Oh, this is nice. There's picnic tables under the trees over there. I reckon that's for staff to come out and have lunch. These are definitely planted trees in nice straight rows. So yeah, I think this is nicely maintained. So this is about as close to the building as we can get legitimately. I'm standing literally a centimetre behind a no public access sign. Well, in front of a no public access sign. And we can see the natural pond just down here. And then up here is what you can hear. There's a waterfall that runs down this bank here. See if I can zoom in on it. And a lovely artificial pond in the middle of the building. The building curves around. Lovely. At this point, I think we're going to leave McLaren. That road there goes off around the back of their site. That's private property. We're going off towards this weird metal cabin and bridge. We're going to head over the river. Doggy having fun. Ooh, it's a little stingy nettly around here. Might have to be jacket on even though it's still warm. The last thing we've come to see today is Fairoaks Airport, tiny little one runway airfield, which we're right on the corner of now, and it's just to our left. But you can't really see much from here. Okay. This is not quite what I was expecting here. I was expecting a bit more in the way of a fence, but okay. It's always a slightly scary sign, because they rarely give you context of what this area is. There's blatantly a footpath across there, and there's a field here. Talks about a dog training ground, but there's very definitely a footpath across there. So we're going to walk across the footpath and across the end of the runway. And we're just not going to stray off to the left. I really was expecting there to be a fence along this footpath. Low flying aircraft do not stop for the next 90 yards. I guess I'm going to stop here and wait for Kerry to catch up. And then we're going across the runway. You can see a massive number 24 there. Again, I'll link to CGP Grey's video on runway numbers. And this is the approach over here. See the sign here says do not stop for the next 90 yards, so do not stop between this sign and the next one up there, because you're crossing the end of the runway.
Okay.
So no stopping to take photos. This is just weird.
I feel really nervous now because I feel like we shouldn't be here.
It does feel like we shouldn't be here, but there's definitely a footpath here, else they wouldn't have those do not stop signs. I'm reckoning that green cabin over there is probably flight control, because there's nothing else that looks sort of like a tower, is there? Around the runway. Not much of a breeze, you can see by the windsock over there. Horses are fighting the tree. They really are very trusting out in the countryside. Mind you, I suppose having a fence that close to the end of the runway might actually be more of a risk if something clips the top of the fence. Back into the trees. That was surreal. There is an unauthorized access prohibited sign here, but it's a bit obscured. That was a bit surreal. What did you think of that?
I was really nervous. It felt like we shouldn't be there.
Yeah, you get some footpaths that are a bit like that. They don't make it clear what where the boundary you're not allowed to cross is. I'm pretty sure it's either side of the footpath there, but they don't make that clear.
No. I feel a bit better now, but...
Now we're in some trees.
Yeah.
But we're still on exactly the same piece of land.
Yeah.
There's nothing really stopping us from... Well, okay, there is here. There's a massive, great big blackberry bush. There's nothing really stopping us from walking through those trees and out onto the airfield. It's a great display of trust. Well, I think that's about it for this walk today. We've seen the three things we came to see. I've checked the flight tracker and there are no more flights from this airport today, unfortunately, so I won't get to film one of them. We're now just going to turn around, walk the same route back, so this video will probably end here, but if we see anything else interesting on the way back, you'll get to see that right at the end of the video. So thank you very much for joining us. Hope you enjoyed it. If you'd like to like and subscribe, that would be great. And I'll see you again next week. Looks like this house has carved a tree into a totem.
Bring it back for me. No, the ball's more important.